Hello students, this is Jason with the second part of our chemical reactions and chemical equations. In this module we will be discussing about balancing a chemical equation. So last topic we have already discussed about how a chemical reaction is written and all. So in this module we will be discussing what is the purpose of balancing a chemical equation. As we have discussed, magnesium on burning in a oxygen produces magnesium oxide. This was the topic we were discussing in the first part, right? So in the formation of magnesium oxide, if you look at LHS and RHS, LHS and RHS, here I have mentioned is LHS means the reactant part and RHS means the product part. Here magnesium we have only one atom of magnesium only, and oxygen we have two atoms of oxygen forms one molecule of oxygen. So one molecule of oxygen reacted with one atom of magnesium for the formation of one molecule of magnesium oxide. Here in right hand side also Mg is also one, you can see one magnesium and oxygen is also one. To balance this in both the sides, because here oxygen two are there, here one is only there. So what we do is we cannot add two over here. Instead of that, we will make a box over here, and we put a coefficient two. Simply when it is magnesium MgO, it is one MgO only. We don't normally represent it as one MgO. We will write simply MgO only. When you write 2 over here, this coefficient is becoming common for Mg as well as O. That is, we have already studied in the mathematics, A into B plus C is equal to AB plus AC. That is, A into B as well as A into C. So this same condition only comes here also. This 2 is multiplied for both Mg as well as O. Here, this 2, when you multiply with 1, this you will get Mg2 as well as oxygen also 2, right? Now, now what happened here? Here magnesium only 1, so what we will put? We will put 2 over here so that it will come 1 into 2, it is 2. Now, 2 atoms of magnesium on reacting with the 2 atoms, so it is 1 molecule of oxygen. Formation of two molecules of a magnesium oxide is formed. If you did not understand this, I will tell you one simple example, that is water molecules formation. Formation of water. So in formation of water, that is hydrogen on reacting with the oxygen produces water molecule H2O. Here also almost similar cases where two atoms of hydrogen reacted with two atoms of oxygen to form one molecule of water, right? Here hydrogen is 2, here hydrogen is 2, oxygen is 2, but here oxygen is 1 only. Why this is happening, or what is the purpose of balancing the equation? Now I will explain with respect to law of conservation of mass. What is the purpose of mainly balancing the equation is to follow the law of conservation of mass. According to it, the reactant side as well as product side, you cannot actually change the you cannot change the amount of substance reacted must be equal to the product formed. That is actually, and mass can neither be created nor be destroyed. That is the first law. So according to that mass point of view, I am talking about molecular atomic mass of hydrogen is 1 and atomic mass of oxygen is 16. Now 2 atoms of hydrogen are there, so 2 into 16, right? Now 1 into 2 is 2, total comes, and this is comes 2 into 16 is 32. Yes. Now let us look at the right hand side. Here, two atoms of hydrogen, that is 2 into 1, plus one atom of oxygen 16. Yes. Now if you total these two, 2 plus 32, you get a 34U. Is it correct? Now, 2 into 1 is 2 plus 16, total comes 18U only. Now see, why I said this reaction is, this equation is wrong. Why? Because according to the law of conservation of mass, mass can neither be created nor be destroyed. Here, 34U of reactant reacted to form only 18U of water. So that's the what we say, that is the wrong concept what we are conveying by writing this unbalanced equation. So now what we need to do is balance this equation. How can you balance this one is, you cannot put 2 over here. If you put 2 here, this substance of H2O molecule itself has changed. Why? Because H2O2 is another substance only, that is hydrogen peroxide only. So you may please box it so that it will not be affected inside. So you put a 2 over here. Now by putting these 2, oxygen has actually doubled. Oxygen became a 16 into 2. 16 into 2 is 16 2s are 32. 32 plus 2. Now here also, this is common for hydrogen also, so 2 into 2, it becomes a 4. So 4 plus 32, it becomes a 36U. Now you see, here it is 34U and this is 36U. Again problem comes. Now what we have to do is, hydrogen 2 only here, so you put a 2 over here. Why I am making a box over here? So that you will not enter anything inside into it. So that this everything twice the in hydrogen, so 2 into 2 it becomes a 4. This is you can write like this, 2 into 2, that is 4. 4 plus 32, total comes a 36U. Now you look here, left hand side is 36U and right hand side is also 36U, right? You understood this? Now let us look at a simple example which is given in NCERT textbook. There is a question given in a NCERT textbook that let us study. That is, iron Fe on reacting with the H2O molecule, it produces Fe3O4. Fe3O4 plus hydrogen. This is the question given in NCERT as a equation for balancing the chemical equation. Now if you look here, step by step we will go as it is given in the NCERT textbook. First of all, you have to make a box over all these reactants as well as the product sites, so that you will not make any changes in this total any of this either reactant or to the products. Now you look at this this one here, left side we have iron, then we have hydrogen atoms. I am writing one by one. Hydrogen, another one is oxygen. Here iron is 1, hydrogen is 2 atoms of hydrogen, oxygen 1, and in the right hand side Fe 3 are there, hydrogen here 2 are there, and oxygen is 4. So the simplest way in this balancing the equation is, find out the highest number of atoms present either in reactant side or product side. Okay, either in the reactant side or in the product side. Now we come to know that here it is oxygen. Oxygen is 4 times it is there in right hand side. Now this 4 you can put over here, so that oxygen becomes a 4, right? 4 oxygen atom, here also 4. By putting oxygen 4, what happened? You see here oxygen became 4, here oxygen 4, here oxygen 4. Okay, oxygen is correct. Now by putting oxygen, as I said, a into b plus c will be multiplied a into b as well as a into c. So the same way, this 4 will be applicable for hydrogen also. So 4 into 2 or 2 into 4 is 8. So hydrogen has doubled, or we can say that it is actually 4 times, it is 8 it became. So in order to balance hydrogen, now hydrogen has become a 8. So what we have to put is here also 4. So 4 into 2, that is also became 8. Now what is remaining in this one is iron. Iron in the right hand side, there are 3 atoms. See here, and here there is only 1 atom. So what you have to do, you multiply a 3 before iron, that is put a coefficient as 3. So it iron also becomes 3. Now you see in the left hand side iron is 3, right hand side iron is 3, left hand side hydrogen is 8, right hand side hydrogen is 8, oxygen is 4 and oxygen is 4. By this we have actually balanced this chemical equation. So children, these are some of the examples, 3 examples we have done now. There are so many questions given in the book. You may please practice that also. And if you are having doubts, you may put comments and send it to me. I will try to solve and give reply to you. Okay. Thank you very much.